Part 6. The Jamie Beast's Creation, Battle and Transcendence. Mini Chapter 108. Dud's Bad Morning. From the moment Dud woke up today, he's had a bad morning. First, the LAPD called him at home just after his alarm clock had gone off to inform him his employee, Kelly Kandy, was murdered by an intruder in her home late last night. The murderer was captured at the crime scene by two cops, who radioed the station that they'd arrested him. It seems the perpetrator must have proceeded to overpower them and take control of the cop car, however, because their portable radios and the car radio were tracked down to a deserted Skid Row alleyway while the car and the cops themselves were gone and haven't been located yet. Regarding the criminal's appearance, the only information the cops had given the station was that he was a white male. As for Kelly's death, it looked like a clean, efficient, high-speed throttling, assassination style. What bastard could have done that? Poor Kelly. She was a beauty. And Dud never even got a chance to have his way with her. He'll have to find her a replacement for her now. Then, as if that wasn't enough, the whole of Ain't They Freaky ground to a mysterious halt last night, as Dud was informed by numerous frantic sources on his way into work. All those thousands of content uploads and scores from players around the world have seemingly vanished from the servers at the LAX server farm, just wiped away by some massive glitch. And there wasn't yet any backup system for those uploads and scores either, so they're gone forever. Of course, there are backups of the game's own software itself, so the newsfeed templates can be reinstalled and reactivated. But until they are, those six domains are sitting blank and idle, while Dud's most valuable advertisers have been contacting Banged all morning to cancel lucrative purchase orders. He'll be slave-driving Ashley around the clock to work out what kind of attack it was. Then, as soon as he's had time to find a replacement for her, she will be sacked. He groans aloud. All this stress is giving him a headache. Then a thought occurs to him. Could Jamie be somewhere behind this murder? If those two cops are found alive, and if they say the killer was tall and well-built and blonde and maybe a bit like Rutger Hauer in The Hitcher, then Dud will know exactly who it was, having met that very man more than once. In which case, Dud wouldn't hesitate to notify the police with a view to putting Jamie in prison for murder, industrial espionage and no doubt other charges. There's a difficulty, however. To get Jamie into trouble, Dud would have to point the police towards Amber in one of the advanced publicity images for the Platinum Raven, so as to identify who created Kelly's murderer. But as yet, neither the police nor the public has any idea that Amber and the other beasts are capable of breaking out from the confines of Jamie's games into meat space. No idea that Jamie has succeeded in progressing technically so far down that avenue. As soon as they discover this, Jamie will be the toast of the games industry, and Dud has no wish to trigger such admiration. On the other hand, if people are allowed to continue believing Amber is just an invented character in a story, then Dud can hardly claim that a fictional man killed a real human woman, or he'd soon lose all credibility himself. He groans aloud again. This is truly a long morning.